Hi, friends. Our scripture reading tonight is from the Gospel of John, chapter 12, verses 1 through 8. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, home of Lazarus, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. Lazarus and his sisters hosted a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was among those who sat at the table. Then Mary took an extraordinary amount, almost 3/4 of a pound, of very expensive perfume made of pure nard. She anointed Jesus' feet with it, then wiped his feet dry with her hair. The house was filled with the aroma of the perfume. Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, complained, "This perfume was worth a year's wages. Why isn't it sold and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He carried the money bag and would take what was in it. Then Jesus said, "Leave her alone. This perfume was to be used in preparation for my burial, and this is how she used it. You will always have the poor among you, but you won't always have me." Holy wisdom, holy word. Thanks be to God. Some of you know that I love to run and walk outside. This time of year is one of my favorite seasons for this. When I run in the early morning, it isn't too cold and it isn't too hot. I get to watch the sunrise. The grass is growing greener. The leaves are out on the trees. Flowers are popping up everywhere, especially blue bonnets. All signs of new life, signs of spring and new life are everywhere. I get to watch deer that are fat with their babies that will soon be born grazing in the fields. I get to see baby rabbits scurrying around their mamas, fearful and excited by everything they see. The birds are so loud. They sing as if they're responsible for spring coming into the world. You see spring, you hear spring, new life everywhere. And one of my favorite parts of this year is the smell. The smell of the earth waking up from being dormant all winter as the spring rains dampen the ground and things begin to grow again. There's a wonderful smell that comes along with that. It's kind of musty and damp, but it's like you can smell spring. In our passage today, there are signs of new life as well. Lazarus was among those who joined Jesus at the table. Lazarus, who was dead, and then Jesus raised him up. Lazarus is with Jesus at the table. Imagine that sight. Imagine the celebration in the air. Friends, these signs of new life can bring us a new sense of optimism and hope. When we see that growth, we're reminded that we too can experience growth no matter our age. Growth in our minds, growth in the health of our bodies, and growth in the health of our spirits. Take advantage of that inspiration that new life brings. Will you pray with me? Most loving God, we are grateful for all the signs of new life that surround us everywhere. Help us use it to inspire us to go out and grow in our love towards you and towards our neighbors. It's in your name that we pray. Amen.
Hope and power in